Boxing trainer, the trainer Manny Pacquiao, said this week that the king of our era, the king of boxing for this generation, is Floyd Mayweather. And I want to know, what do you guys say about that? Mayweather, 49-0. But it's not only 49-0, as Mikey Garcia, the boxing superstar, 34-0, 28 knockouts, recently posted. Mikey said, hey, it's not that Mayweather's 49-0 like Marciano. It's that Mayweather fought 26 champions. Current champions in his fight and former champions. And it's how he dominated, taking so little punishment, making the insane amounts of money. Manny Pacquiao, one of the most exciting fighters I've ever seen, probably most exciting fighters in the history of boxing. His knockouts, the Ricky Hatton knockout, some of his other sensational victories, which is something out of this world. Manny Pacquiao is a game changer. Me, myself, I didn't know a lot about the Philippines. I just met Filipinos, of course. They're very friendly, very nice, very respectful, always joking, always smiling. But because of Manny, I learned about the culture, about the balut, about why they call it the Philippines. Because when the Spaniards came over there 300 years ago, they named it Philippines over Prince Philip in Spain. And all kinds of things that, because of Manny, I'm now knowledgeable about the Philippines. He is a great person, a big heart. And he does a lot in the community. Not to say that Mayweather doesn't, because Mayweather does a lot of stuff, but it's just different in how they approach it. Mayweather does it very low-key, but I know personally, from personal experience, that Mayweather has done big things to help people who have passed away, and Mayweather's chipped in to help them, help their families time and time again. It's happened numerous times where a family doesn't have money to bury their loved ones, and Mayweather comes through. Manny Pacquiao is building a hospital. He gives boats to poor people. He does what he can to help people. Both are great people. Both are great fighters. Mayweather, the record speaks for itself. 49-0. Manny Pacquiao just meant so much to so many people. He was on the cover of Time magazine. But you also have fighters like Miguel Cotto, who are probably going to retire soon. He still has some left in the game, but his career is closer to the end than the beginning. Vladimir Klitschko, when he fights in Europe, he packs 60,000 in a stadium. He makes $20 million. He has an insane following. We'll see how his rematch goes with Tyson Fury whenever that happens. But he's also about to end his career sooner than later. And Sergio Martinez, his career is done. Margarito, his career is done. So many fighters that we grew up in the recent years that were a main attraction for us. This is the period of changing of the guard, where you have the Canelo era. You have Triple G. You have Chocolatito. You have the Leo Santa Cruzes. You have Tug Sue from, I'm telling you, this guy you got to look out for. His name is Tug Sue. He won a silver medal. Should have won the gold in the Olympics. Got robbed. It doesn't matter. He trains with Joe Goosen at Goosen Gym. This kid is with only 4 pro fights, 4 knockouts, and already fighting 10 rounders. This kid, he reminds me a lot of a young Manny Pacquiao. Lighter weight, 118, but just a monster. And you have the Neno Saul Rodriguez, another babyface assassin. You have Felix Verdejo, another fighter to look out for. And so many, so many young fighters that are up and coming that in the next couple of years will take over the sport. But this is right now, we're in a twilight zone of changing of the guards, where the Mayweathers, the Pacquiao's are kind of riding into the sunset, and the new generation, the Gervonta Davis, who's fighting this weekend in Vegas on December 18th, another bright star. Or you have Devin Haney, who just turned pro. He had a knockout in 35 seconds. I've seen him spar pros that are undefeated with many knockouts, and he does great with them. That's another kid to look out for. Ryan Garcia at Goosen Gym. He fought Devin Haney 5 times, and he beat him 3. Now, in the amateurs, it's not pros, but still, it just shows that there's a lot of boxing talent, not only here in the U.S., but worldwide. And the sport is doing better now than 7 years ago and 6 years ago. I feel it. When I go into gyms, the gyms are packed. So if you had to choose who's the best fighter of our era, who do you go with? And there are no wrong answers, because everybody has their favorite. For YousNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EllieSeckback. Of course, there's so many fighters I can mention that you can add to the new generation. You have the Adrian Broner, the Danny Garcia, the Deontay Wilder, the Keith Thurman, the Sean Porter, the Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. You have Mikey Garcia. You have so many young fighters that are just taking over the sport one day at a time. You have Francisco Vargas, who just had a sensational win. And many, many other fighters. I can't really think of everybody off the top of my head, but there's lots and lots of great boxing that's going to come in 2016, and I can't wait. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Elisek Back reporting.